Nerds, welcome to Nerdbuzz. This is going to be my spoiler review for episode 2 of season 7 for Game of Thrones. Spoiler alert, yes, spoilers throughout the entire video, so make sure you've checked out the episode first before you check out this video. Spoilers, you've been warned. It's a good episode. There wasn't many battles in the last episode, but in this we get a big battle at the end, which is great. But the start of it, we pretty much start where we left off. We left off with Daenerys and her entire clan with Tyrion and whatnot. We start there straight in with some dialogue and some plotting, some planning and deciding what to do. And also a little bit of a standoff with her and Varys deciding his intentions, because obviously he was part of with King Robert about assassinating her when she was back where she was in season 1. So it's finding out where his allegiances lie and making sure that his allegiances do lie with her, and if he ever has a problem is to come and tell her as a woman and not do it behind her back and try and get her killed. So it's that confrontation was good, because you need to solidify why he's there, kind of thing, because obviously Varys is a very slippery character. He's a very good character, but he's a very slippery character, so you're never truly sure of his full intentions. He's very similar to Littlefinger, but less devious, I would say. It's a really good plan what they've got. They're basically going to, instead of just attacking Westeros, they're going to attack different ports for like Lannister, like Casterly Rock. They're going to send all the Unsullied in there as well to get them sorted out. You're also going to get all the naval guys for Meera and Theon. They're going to head off towards King's Landing and trying to take that down. So they're taking down separate parts so that when they finally go for King's Landing, everybody's going to be behind them anyway, which is a good idea. And then you get the Red Woman, Mansandra. She appears, so we know where she is now. She's at Dragonstone with Daenerys trying to talk to her. And then they have a quick conversation about Jon as well. Tyrion gets his little chime in about Jon. It's really, I tell you what, it's a wonderful thing finally seeing someone like Daenerys hear about Jon Snow and talk about her. And then subsequently hearing Jon Snow talk about Daenerys when they send him a note to invite him to pop over and bend the knee, kind of thing. And obviously he has to go there because that's where the Dragonglass is. So the stories are beginning to become woven together. And just hearing them talk about each other, it gets me so excited for when they finally meet. Yes, yeah, so as I said, Jon Snow, he decides to leave Winterfell to go to Dragonstone to see Daenerys, to kind of sort out a deal with Dragonglass and so on and so forth. I'm pretty sure he probably will bend the knee, to be honest, because I don't think he wants to be in charge. He's not a king, he doesn't want to be a king, he just wants peace and make sure that everyone's alive and happy and well. He's just a good, noble character, kind of like what Ned is. And he leaves it in charge of Sansa, and you've got Littlefinger still doing his ways. You even have a moment with him and Jon down in the crypt by Ned's grave. And it's really creepy. He's really basically saying he loved his mother, and then he also loves Sansa. And then Jon throat straight into the wall to him to stay away from Sansa. So that, the tension's getting there. I'm worried about Littlefinger, obviously, because now Jon's not there. Will he worm his way into Sansa? My guess is I don't think he will. I don't think he'll think like he is. He'll think he's getting somewhere, and she'll make it feel like he's getting under her skin and, twisting her, and at the final moment she'll kill him or something of that effect, and that'll be cool. The scene with the Cersei this week as well, we're talking to the Grand Maester? I think he's now the Hand of the King as well. I think it's him anyway. They go down to the crypts where all the old skulls of the other dragons are, and they've got this massive crossbow that can kill a dragon basically, and they just go, one thing I quite like about this scene is, I know it's kind of exposition and everything, but it's good to finally see a weakness in Daenerys' army, or a chink in her chain, because so far she's holding all the cards. She's got the army, she's got the people, she's got the dragons, And there's nothing that seems to be a chink, and this seems to be the first chink where, if they can be injured, they can be killed. And, I think, if you've got to have a big blow to Cersei's army, it's killing a dragon. The scene with Sam this week, we've got Greyscale, Jorah, it's really getting bad, and they're trying to find ways to do it, and the Grand Maesters and everything are basically just saying it's not going to happen, we can't do it, we can't do anything, you've got a day and you're going to die, blah blah blah, in a few weeks. And Sam, behind their back, decides to try and treat him and take off the Greyscale, like big scabs, and it was a really gruesome scene, getting in with the pus and the blood. But the transition I liked was really disgusting. Just as he stabs in, it transitions to someone eating a pie. And Scenes with Arya this week as well. Again, more character building. You see her in Hot Pie. Hot Pie's back and he got fat. Well, fatter. He's back and he kind of delivers the exposition news of that Jon's now King of the North and he's got Winterfell back. And straight away, she's off to Winterfell. But it's so bittersweet because finally we're going to get this moment with them together and Jon fucks off to Dragonstone, so she's not going to get there in time. It really is upsetting because I want to see these guys together. Also with Arya, Nymeria, the direwolf she sent away in season 1, has been running around with a pack of wolves. She's in charge of the wolves and they had a moment together. and then Amira went off and with the Wolves, and that was it. It's a very small moment, didn't really do much, but just to know that the Direwolf is definitely still alive is great. I don't know what they're going to do with that, I don't know whether that's going to further at any point, but it was still a cool moment to see. Final battle scene, didn't see it coming at all, not this kind of scale. You've got Theon, Amira, and the Mother from Dawn, totally forgotten her name. Anyway, it looks like these two girls are about to start getting it on, and they get knocked aside by the ship. Outside is a full massive naval fleet. Not had a naval fleet before, and this was, you know, a naval battle before, and this was really cool to see. Euron Greyjoy's here, and he's busy attacking, he's absolutely destroying, the fire bombs everywhere, blood, guts, massive epic naval battle. And he kills two of the three Sand Snakes, the three daughters, two of them are dead. It's really solidifying Euron as a badass, because we know in the books he is quite a badass character, but we didn't see much of that in the series so far. But this has solidified him as this crazy, unhinged badass, and it's really quite awesome to see. And finally he takes the Dawn Mother, again, forgot her name, takes her and the last Sand Snake hostage, and he's got hold of Mira, and Theon's there looking at him, and he tries to coach Theon to come and get her and stop her, but then he has that kind of thing, because obviously he's such a traumatized character, and he bails. He jumps out into the water, and then he takes her hostage. I thought she was dead. I thought he was just going to slit her throat and that was it, but she's also been taken hostage. All of these people are probably going to Cersei as that gift that he said he was going to give her. So I'm pretty sure that they're going to be dead anyway. It's going to be quite an horrific death for them, but I'm pretty sure they're as good as dead. But it really pains me to see Theon bail and jump into the water. But saying that, what could he have done? I mean, unless he had an arrow ready and had it with absolute precision timing, he wouldn't have been able to get across that ship quick enough to stop him from killing his sister. It wouldn't have happened. But still, it's a heartbreaking moment to see. Overall, guys, episode 2 for season 7. Great episode, really getting into the thick of it now, because we've got obviously battles and we've got more things happening. Great thing about this is, because we've got less episodes and we're coming to the end, you know, the penultimate end of this entire thing, the speed is starting to, you know, really increase. We're going to get more and more stuff like this. Even in the preview from next week, you see that there's potentially going to be two big battles just in one episode. So the fact that we're just, the speed is getting faster and faster through these episodes, it's going to be awesome. And this is a good episode, solid episode, good character building, epic naval battle, and you know, again, it's got me pumped for the next episode. So that's what I thought of episode 2 of season 7 of Game of Thrones. What did you think about it? Let me know down in the comments, or send me an email. You can also find me in the various social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, moviepilot.com. just type in Nerdbytes anywhere and I'm sure you'll find me, and don't forget to like, subscribe and share my videos, and of course, keep it nerdy.